Dear friends, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect this 1-inch OLED display with a Raspberry Pi Pico board. I will also show you how to use it with CircuitPython, and I will share with you 3 useful projects to help you get started and save you a lot of time. Let's start. This OLED display is one of my favorite displays of all time. I have used it in many Arduino projects in the past, and I really like it because it is inexpensive. It costs around $4. It is very easy to use. It has low power consumption and great contrast. The display has a resolution of 128 by 64 pixels. It is monochrome, and it uses the I2C interface to communicate with a microcontroller. The connection with the Raspberry Pi Pico is very easy. All we have to do is to connect power and 2 more wires. The first pin of the display is the ground pin, so we connect it to a ground pin of the Raspberry Pi Pico board. The second pin of the display is VCC, so we connect it to the 3.3V output of the board, which is right here. The next pin of the board is named SEL, so we connect it to the SEL pin of the board, which is pin GP1. The fourth pin is named SDA, so we connect it to the SDA pin of the board, which is pin GP0. Easy, wasn't it? Our connections are ready. Let's power up the board to see what happens. As you can see, the display works and it displays a demo script, a simple Pong game where both paddles are controlled by the Raspberry Pi Pico. Cool. As you can see, the Raspberry Pi Pico board is fast enough to let us develop games on it. Let's now see the software we need to drive this display. In order to use the display with CircuitPython, we need to download the Adafruit Display.io SSD1306 library to drive the display and some other helper libraries. If you want to recreate all the projects I'm going to show you, you need to install the following libraries: the Adafruit Display.io SSD1306, the Adafruit Display Text, the Adafruit Display Shapes, and the Adafruit Bitmap Fonts libraries. To install the libraries, we have to download the CircuitPython Libraries bundle from this link and unzip it on our computer. Since I developed all the projects using CircuitPython 8, we need to download the bundle for CircuitPython 8. Now all we have to do is to locate the needed libraries and copy and paste them inside the lib folder in the CircuitPy drive, just like this. Additionally, we also need a font file. In the CircuitPy drive, we create a new folder and we give it the name Fonts. Inside the Fonts folder, we copy the terminal font file. Your CircuitPy drive should now look like this. We have a code.py file with a script to run on the board, a fonts folder with a font file, and a lib folder with all the libraries required. You can find links to all the files needed in the video description. The first example program is a simple project which just displays a white frame and a hello world text. I am using Thorny as my editor. As you can see, the code also supports the LilyGo ESP32S2 board or any other board that can run CircuitPython if you define the correct I2C pins here. The second example is a simple version of a Pong game where the CPU is controlling both paddles. The project consists of 3 files and you have to copy all of them in the CircuitPy drive and run the code.py script. The aim of the project was to test if the Raspberry Pi Pico is fast enough to allow us to build some games with it. It turns out it is. The animation is very smooth and it looks even better in person. There is no flickering at all in reality. Very cool. I think I can expand this game to make it playable. Are you interested? Let me know in the comment section below. The last project is a simple thermometer project. This project does not require an external temperature sensor since it uses the temperature sensor that already exists on the Raspberry Pi Pico board. The temperature sensor is not very accurate, but this project is just a demonstration. This small degree symbol is the reason we need to load an external font in this project. The embedded font in CircuitPython does not include it. The project updates the temperature every second. Notice that there is no flickering at all. The update of the display is instant. As you can see, the code is pretty simple. Of course, the code is simple if you know how to code in Python. If you don't know how to code in Python, or if you don't know how to code at all, don't worry. The fundamentals are very easy to learn. I have prepared a detailed free course on my second channel about Python programming. It will teach you the basics in just a couple of hours. If you are interested in learning Python or CircuitPython, check it out now. I think it will help you a lot. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.